I'm 75 years old, and I've had so many amazing experiences. And I think that's the problem with most people's lives. They stop and they become stale. And they don't realize they could do more for other people. And it just takes one step to change the community just by a kind gesture. The samurai tradition is part of my family heritage. And many people don't know that the word samurai means to serve. That philosophy has been in my family for generations, and that's how my parents helped me how to live. Wow, this is my dad. My father was in the US military during World War II. He had to stay in Tokyo, Japan after the war, and that's where I was born in 1947. I was 9 years old when we moved back to California in West Los Angeles. Here's my sixth grade elementary school picture. And all you have to do is look for the littlest guy right about there. That's me, hidden below the striped shirt, always hiding. Most of the kids my age, their fathers all served in the war against the Japanese. I was always picked on and got bullied quite a lot because of my Japanese heritage. I was always looking for something to excel in, but it wasn't until high school that a friend of mine said, you know what, there's a karate exhibition, would you like to go see it? That evening, that changed my whole life. When I started, I was probably the worst one ever. We would actually have 4-hour classes, dripping wet. I had bruised and cracked ribs, but I just kept coming back because they encouraged me to come back. They said, you know, you could be better, you could be good. And I said, I could. Each time I did a technique, it was like destroying the bullies that picked on me. And because of that experience and being around great leaders in the karate world, that's what helped me mold from that point on. By the time I was 20, I achieved the rank of black belt. I was no longer afraid of bullies that picked on me.
Bruce says he's growing up kind of thinking of himself as the underdog, but I think sometimes he still kind of sees himself that way, always kind of pushing to excel. That's just his nature.
It's interesting because in my art class, I realized I could push my students just like karate practice. So they in turn became black belts in art. The kids who lack confidence, I would spend more time with them. And I would have 30 to 40 kids every day at lunch for 25 years in my classroom. I say, hey, come in the room. And kids who were bullied, that was the only safe haven. Many times they say, you're the first teacher that ever complimented me.
Bruce is everybody's cheerleader. That person who just is ready to rally the troops, you know, kind of like, da-da-da-da, you know, like, let's get going. And it's contagious.
I would say there's thousands of times I don't want to go train in karate. I don't want to go to class today. I don't want to teach. My body hurts. I'm so tired. I just want to take a nap. And I'll go because of them. because I know somebody needs my teaching that day. All the time I see myself and the students, all the time. Every one of my karate students, I said, I hope one day you can become better than me. And not for me to get awards and honors. I want to have my students get that. The word samurai means to serve. So that's instilled in me, I mean, etched into my heart.
Good form, Kate. Outstanding, just outstanding. You have no idea what a leader you're becoming.
Sometimes just a compliment can change the community just by a kind gesture. I wish everybody would embrace that. Our whole society, the whole world would change. Hey, good job.